We are at the West Cincinnati supercharging location. It's fairly new. There's not even a gate around the supercharging cabinets yet. They have 12 stalls here, but what's really intriguing are these white boxes that are a relatively new addition and also being retrofitted onto a lot of the new superchargers. Retrofitted onto the old superchargers. What these are autotransformers, and they help stabilize input voltage coming from the utility, help get rid of any waiver, and I'm also told that they help correct power factor so as not to disrupt utility harmonics, for the power harmonics. I don't know how the best way to explain it is, but has some sort of power factor correction. I cannot verify this 100%, but I was told by a supercharging installing crew that I happened across about 3 months ago, but I had not gotten to see these in person quite as yet. So it's a neat addition. So that way, if utility power, grid power that is not very clean or not very stable, they would potentially have less supercharging issues, and told that reduced service, so such as a case where the supercharger might not be outputting its full capacity, these might help with that issue, so that way the supercharger can run at their maximum capacity. So that's about all I got for you on these right now. They are UL listed. I'm going to do some more searching for information online. Yep, oh, there we go. 160 auto KVA. I should have looked at that a little more detailed, but it's really cold out right now. But KVA, 160 kilovolt amperes, three phase. Very cool. It looks like they might be able to get quite hot. According to the label, expect a high temperature rise. So it's not something you're going to see. Oh, they're even labeled Autotransformer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The supercharging cabinets, just as a comparison to the more original and older ones. It's nice and warm. Supercharger cabinets, while really not too much different than what I've seen in the past, a big difference is they are now more refined. They don't look like they were hodgepodged together per se, or just, you know, built from random metal. I don't know the best way to put it, but it's more refined. They're sealed better. Overall fit and finish, just like the cars have been improving, the supercharger cabinet build has been improving as well. So there's a look at a pretty much brand new installation. So we're going to charge a little while more and head on down to London, Kentucky. We're making our way to Pigeon Forge. 12 supercharging stations running off of 6 superchargers. That is a lot of power.